Welcome to the University of Rochester Pathology Video Series. This video reviews the normal histology of the pancreas. Using the NanoZoom digital pathology slides available in the U of R Histology folder, we will examine the microscopic anatomy of the pancreas. Feel free to locate slide 66 and follow along as we explore the pancreas cross-section. The majority of the pancreas is composed of acinar cells, which comprise the exocrine pancreas. The endocrine-functioning islets of Langerhans confirm that we are looking at the pancreas and not the parotid, which lacks endocrine function. First, let's examine the histology of the exocrine pancreas. These triangular, or pyramidal, secretory cells are called acini and comprise more than 80% of the adult pancreas. The nuclei are basally located and the cytoplasm is very granular. The granules differ between the apical and basal cytoplasms, and the granularity is the result of a high density of organelles. Here is a compact islet of Langerhans with well-defined borders and coarse speckled chromatin. Compact islets make up the majority of the endocrine pancreas. A small fraction of the total islet cells are more diffusely spread through the acini. In neonates, islets of Langerhans comprise about 20% of the pancreas, but only 1 to 2% of the total organ in adults. There are four types of endocrine cells: beta cells, alpha cells, delta cells, and PP cells. Each is present in varying concentrations and with distinct functionality, but it is not possible to discern the differences between the cells at this level of microscopic staining. Beta cells tend to be located centrally in the islets and may have larger nuclei. PP cells are very rare and make up the majority of diffuse islet cells. The pancreas contains a large amount of connective tissue. The septi divide lobes of the pancreas. We see arteries, veins, and capillaries throughout the connective tissue. Here is an artery and vein and more connective tissue in the center of the image. In the lower right of the frame, we see our first large pancreatic duct. The pancreatic ducts are characterized by columnar mucous epithelium. They have round nuclei which are located on the basal layer. Here is a closer image of a duct. The larger ducts have more rectangular columnar epithelium, whereas ducts within acinar lobules contain shorter, more cuboidal epithelium. This interlobular duct epithelium is a transition between the columnar and cuboidal epithelium. Here is an example of a larger duct. The epithelium is more columnar than cuboidal. Here is an intercalated duct. As an intralobular pancreatic duct, intercalated ducts are found among the acinar cells rather than being surrounded by connective tissue. The smallest of the pancreatic ducts, intercalated ducts have cuboidal epithelium. In review, pancreas histology may be divided into acini, islets, and ducts. Acinar cells make up the majority of the pancreatic lobules and are densely packed with organelles and basal nuclei. There are four types of islet cells, but they are essentially indistinguishable through H&E staining. The pancreatic ducts are lined by epithelium, which varies from cuboidal to columnar. This concludes our review of normal pancreatic histology.